I have installed SageMath 9.1, and এখন আমি SageMath 9.1 নোটবুকে ঢুকছি, অর্থাৎ আই এম এন্টারিং দ্য ওয়ার্ল্ড অফ SageMath. আই এম এন্টারিং দ্য ওয়ার্ল্ড অফ SageMath. বিফোর এন্টারিং মানে আই ওয়ান্ট টু ওপেন এগেইন SageMath সেল. সেই জন্য আমি একটা গুগল এতে যাচ্ছি. আচ্ছা, আমার স্ক্রিনটা দেখা যাচ্ছে তো? স্ক্রিন দেখা যাচ্ছে তো?
হ্যাঁ স্যার, দেখা যাচ্ছে.
ইয়েস স্যার, দেখা যাচ্ছে.
SageMath সেল, SageMath সেল টাইপ করলাম. সেজ সেল সার্ভার এটা পেলে এখান থেকে এটা ক্লিক করে আমি এই SageMath সেলে গেলাম. সাপোজ এখানে আমি লিখছি 2+3 ইভ্যালুয়েট 2+3 ইভ্যালুয়েট, দেন আমার আনসার হচ্ছে 5. Suppose A is equal to 5. Suppose A is equal to 5. A is equal to 5. Then I want to calculate A to the power 5. Then A caret 5. Then evaluate.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes. Is there any
problem? Can you please explain it in English or Hindi? We are not comfortable with Bengali.
Okay, this is the SageMath cell. You can write code here, you can write your calculation, then if you click the evaluate button, then you will get the answer. For example, here A is 5, I want to calculate A to the power 5, then A is 5, A equal to 5, and then A caret 5. This is the SageMath syntax. A to the power 5. I want to calculate A to the power 5. The A caret 5. Then evaluate. You will get the answer 3125. Okay?
Hello.
3125. Suppose Hello. This is B is equal to, B is another variable, B is equal to 45.
Hello.
Then we want to A plus.
Sorry for the interruption, sir. Sir, are you showing your screen? What are you writing the program in your computer?
My screen is not showing. Our screen is not showing.
We can see only the screen. হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, স্ক্রিনটা শুধু দেখা যাচ্ছে, কিন্তু আপনি যে কি প্রোগ্রামটাও টাইপ করছেন বা লিখছেন সেই জায়গাটা
দেখা যাচ্ছে? SageMath সেল দেখা যাচ্ছে কি?
স্যার বেসিক্যালি, সরি স্যার, বেসিক্যালি ওটা দেখা যাচ্ছে না. আমরা দেখতে পাচ্ছি আপনি যে পিডিএফটা ওপেন করেছেন.
ওকে, তার মানে আমার পিডিএফ থেকে এটাকে বেরিয়ে যেতে হবে পিডিএফ থেকে.
হ্যাঁ স্যার, স্যার আপনার ওই হোল স্ক্রিন যদি আপনি শেয়ার করেন শেয়ার স্ক্রিনে গিয়ে, তাহলে সবটাই দেখতে পাবো আমরা.
ওকে 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 ওকে, থ্যাংক ইউ থ্যাংক ইউ
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার.
হোল স্ক্রিন
Thank you.
Full screen to the day.
I am unable to share full screen. Can you help me? Am I audible? Amar shona jacche?
Yes sir, you are completely audible.
Yes sir.
কিন্তু আমি তো ফুল স্ক্রিন শেয়ার করার কোনো অপশন পাচ্ছি না, কেউ কি একটু হেল্প করবেন? মানে আমি এটা কমফোর্টেবল না, আমি জুম অ্যাপ
এটা কমফোর্টেবল নিকি স্যার একবার PDF টা অফ করে
PDF টা অফ করব স্টপ শেয়ারিং করে
স্যার স্টপ শেয়ারিং করে নতুন করে শেয়ার করুন তখন ফুল স্ক্রিনটা শেয়ার করবেন
শেয়ার স্ক্রিন ফুল স্ক্রিনের অপশন তো আমাকে দিচ্ছে না
স্যার কি কি অপশন
স্ক্রিন হোয়াইট বোর্ড আইফোন স্ক্রিন
স্ক্রিন
থেকে স্যার
হ্যাঁ
ওকে ওকে
হ্যাঁ স্যার এবারে একদম ঠিক আছে এবারে আপনি যা দেখাবেন আমরা দেখতে পাবো
ওকে
হ্যাঁ স্যার এবারে পুরোটা দেখা যাচ্ছে
মানে আমার স্ক্রিনটা দেখা যাচ্ছে তো
অ্যাবসলিউটলি স্যার আপনার গোটা ডেস্কটপ স্ক্রিন আমরা দেখতে পাচ্ছি
ওকে ওকে ওকে
হ্যাঁ
হ্যাঁ আচ্ছা 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 এইটা সেজ ম্যাথ সেল দিস ইজ সেজ ম্যাথ সেল সেল উইন্ডো সেজ ম্যাথ সেল উইন্ডো এই উইন্ডোর সেজ ম্যাথ সেজ সেল ডট সেজ ম্যাথ ডট ওয়ার্জি এই সেজ ম্যাথ সেল উইন্ডো ইফ ইউ রাইট এনি কোড অ্যান্ড ক্লিক অন ইভালুয়েট দেন ইউর কোড উইল বি এক্সিকিউটেড ইউর কোড উইল বি এক্সিকিউটেড সাপোজ হেয়ার ইজ 5 অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ 45 then you want to add a plus a to b then a plus b type a plus b okay suppose you want to calculate a to the power 5 that means 5 to the power 45 it will be a large number okay now it is visible
yes sir
yes sir it is okay. yes sir completely visible
এটা মানে ইউ ক্যান কপি দ্য কোড ফ্রম এনি এডিটার অ্যান্ড দেন পেস্ট ইট অ্যান্ড ইভ্যালুয়েট দেন ইউ উইল গেট দ্য অ্যানসার নাও ইট ইজ অ্যান্ড এনি মানে আদার ওয়ে ইউজিং অনলাইন এডিটার ইজ দ্য কোকেল ইজ ইট কোকেল ইফ আই টাইপ কোকেল in google from any editor and the testing okay then first option I click the first option then I'll get this window something is loading connecting and again loading then start project I am clicking okay well then welcome to kokel and if I click any one of these two file or upload you can create a new since we are using SageMath then we will take the SageMath option okay now I am opening this file then this interface you will get this is known as this cell is known as input cell you can type here the code then enter b equal to go into the next line you need to press enter then d is equal to 3. Suppose we want to again want to find a to the power b, a caret b, then to execute you have to press shift enter, press shift then enter, press shift enter, then answer will be 8, 8 to the power b, 2 to the power 3, that is 8. Okay, now I am coming into the install version of Sage. In my system I have installed SageMath 9.1. If you install SageMath cell, then you will have three icons. One is SageMath 9.1, SageMath 9.1 cell, and other is SageMath 9.1 notebook. And click on this icon. It will take some time to open. Please wait. Now, notebook server is connecting. And after some time, it will give an interface, which is known as Jupyter Notebook. Here we see that this is not the Jupyter Notebook. Here we say that to the right there are two buttons. One is upload. Using this button you can upload your file from your system, and if you click new, then you will get two options: Python 3, SageMath 9.1. since we are using SageMath 9.1, we need to click SageMath 9.1. click on the it and you will get a new window, and you will get this interface. Here this is the input cell. Here you can write your code and you can write your command, etc. There are so many icons and so many buttons here. You can explore all these things, and at the top there is Untitled 12. This is the title of the your notebook. You can change it. If you click here, you will get rename option. Rename. Enter a new notebook name. You can give your own name. Okay. Then click rename. Suppose here you can type again a is equal to 3, then b is equal to 34, then you can calculate your own calculation. Suppose A plus B plus 23. Then to run, there are two options. There is a run button. You can click on run, or again you can press shift then enter. First press shift then enter. Then answer is 60. Then a new input set is created. If you create more input cell, you can press plus. If you can delete some input cell, then this option is used. First select the input cell, then click on cut selected cell. You can explore on its own way. Suppose you want to label some heading, then you need to change this code. There are many options. First two options are very much useful. And if you change it markdown, then you can write your own comment, or you can make a title. For example, I want to make a title. If you want to create a cell which is above the current cell, then you select insert, then insert above cell, then the an input cell will be created above the selected cell. Suppose here I can add a title. To put a title, you need to type hash, then one space, then type your heading. Suppose I want to type basic in SageMath. Basics in SageMath. Then you need to change the code to Markdown. Then shift enter to run the command. Then your title, then the input cell will be disappeared. Your title will be created. You can make also your subheading, etc. Now I am going back to home, Jupyter home. I have created so many files. One is 2 days ago, one is 17 hours ago, like this. I am opening one of them. Introduction plotting with SageMath. This one I am opening. To open this, I need to double click here. Notebook is opening. It is still opening. We have to wait. Some calculation I have done here. Okay. First, I will look at some basic calculations. That is, I will use SageMath as an advanced calculator. Okay. Suppose the first basic calculation we have done one or two operation, basic operation. Then suppose first basic operation is multiplication. Suppose I want to multiply 1, 2, 4. This is my first number. I want to multiply 1, 2, 4 into 3, 4, 5. The 1, 2, 4 to multiply, I need star. Star is used for multiplication. Star is an operator. It is used like other programming languages. It is used for multiplication. Then press shift enter. You can do it in your SageMath cell. Okay. Now suppose I want to calculate. I want to divide 1, 2, 4 divide for divide for division 1 black cells. Suppose 1, 2, 4 divide by 12. Then press shift enter to evaluate. The answer is 31/3. This is exact 31/3. Suppose we want to decimal representation, decimal real value. Then we need to convert one of them to decimal. Suppose 124 divided by 12 point. The 12 point is a decimal number. Then shift enter. You will get the decimal answer. The answer is in decimal form. So next thing, suppose I want to calculate the remainder. So 124 is divided by 12. What is the remainder? To calculate the remainder, we need 124. The remainder, like C or other programming, where percentage operator is used. 124, percentage 12. Then shift enter. You will get the remainder. Sorry, you will get the remainder. If you want to calculate the quotient, suppose in this cell I want to calculate the quotient. To calculate the quotient, we need two black cells. 124, two black cells. 124, this is the operator to calculate the quotient. 124, double slash 12. Then shift 10. You will get the answer. So the answer is 10. This is a special operator in sets. Double slash means to calculate the quotient. To calculate the quotient, double slash. Now, next thing, what can I do? Suppose I want to calculate an expression. So my expression is, suppose 6567 plus 3456 multiply 23. This is plus. Then press shift and enter. Then you will get the answer. Suppose the star do they omit Korean? If you omit the star, then what will happen? Then press shift and enter. You will get an error message. It's an invalid syntax. From this error, you can learn a lot. From the error, you can learn a lot. If bhul hoyeche then star operator is missing. That is why the syntax is invalid. Okay? Star, some operator is needed. Star. Next, what can I do? Next thing, suppose some function, the value of some usual function, elementary function, I want to calculate. Suppose sine of 2, I want to calculate sine of 2. The answer is sine of 2. Exactly. If I want to find the decimal representation of the result, then sine of 2 point, the answer will be in decimal. Okay. Suppose I want to calculate tan. Tan, it says tan, suppose 2020, tan of 2020. The answer will be tan of 2020. Exactly. Suppose I want to decimal. To get the decimal value, there are so many options. Here I am using numerical approximation. Dot n, two round bracket, opening and closing. And press shift enter. You will get the answer in decimal. Here is the answer. This is the answer. Okay. If you take the argument as real number or floating point, then your answer will be floating point or real. If you take argument as an integer, then you will get the exact. Suppose 2 by 3, what will get? The exact value, 2 by 3. If you 2.3, then you will get the decimal. Suppose let's assume that I want only 5 digits. 2.3, 2.3. I want only 5 digits. Then I can take 2 point divided by 3 within dot n within bracketed digits equal to digits equal to suppose 5. Digits equal to 5. 2 point by 3 dot, this is not point, this is dot, dot n, n for numerical approximation. 2 point by 3 dot n within bracketed digits equal to 5, then you will get the numerical approximation. Only 5 digits will be printed. Okay. Next, suppose I want to calculate sine inverse. Sine inverse, that is arc sine. A sine within bracket A, suppose 2 point, so 0.3. You can specify the number of digits dot n within bracketed digits equal to suppose 20. Digits equal to 20. A sine inverse 0.3 dot digits equal to 20. Digits. Okay. A sine. That is the cannot approximate the precision of 70 degrees. Okay. So suppose digit is 5, 4. The answer is 0.30%. Next, I want to calculate the value of some mathematical constant. Suppose I want to calculate the value of pi. Suppose I type pi, then shift enter. The value is pi, exactly. Pi dot n. Dot n, it is a function. So, you know, a round bracket to use for it. It is a function, numerical approximation. A Python syntax. Python syntax, like dot n, the shift enter. You'll get the approximate value of pi. You can specify the number of digits equal to suppose 12. Answer is this. Now Euler number E exactly. Now I need to more input box. Euler number E, suppose I want only 20 digits of the value of E. So the dot n digits equal to 20. Number of digits is 20. Since E is an irrational number, the number of digits is infinite, I am taking only 20. I want only 20 digits. Okay. Now we can find E with the help of exponential function, exp. Exp is an exponential function, exponential of x. So like here E means exponential of 1. You will get E. Now another mathematical constant is golden ratio. We want to find the value of golden ratio. Golden hyphen ratio. It is golden ratio. That means exact value is coming. Now I want numerical approximation. Like golden ratio dot n, then n. I can specify the number of digits equal to 10. By definition, golden ratio is the limiting value of the n plus 1 term by n term of the Fibonacci series. The limit f n plus 1 by f n limiting n to infinity is the golden ratio. This can be verified using sets. There is an inbuilt function Fibonacci of 1, when first phenomenon. Fibonacci 1, when first Fibonacci phenomenon. That means 1. If you write Fibonacci 10, then you will get the 10th Fibonacci number. Okay, 10th Fibonacci number is 55. I am taking the ratio Fibonacci of suppose 20 by Fibonacci of 19 f n plus 1 by f n, then numerical approximation dot n round bracket. The value is 1.61, the very very close to the value of the golden ratio. So if you increase the if you type Fibonacci 200 by Fibonacci 199, then these two numbers will be very very near, very equal. Therefore, golden ratio is the limiting value of nth Fibonacci number by n minus 1 Fibonacci number. This is verified. Now next, I want some number theory function. Suppose I want to calculate GCD of two numbers. There is an inbuilt function GCD. Before that, suppose I want to find the factors of 12. There is a function factor of 12, then press shift enter. The 2 to the power 2 start 3. This is the prime factor represents the prime number. 12 is equal to 2 to the power 20 star 3. And list of factors, if you type list of factors of 12, then what list of factors of 12 is not defined. Here is the factors 2 to the power 2 and 3 to the power 1. I mean factors are 2 and 3. 2 is present as a factor as a power 2, a 3 as a power 1. We can find factorial. There is a function factorial of suppose 33. It is a large number. Factorial of 23. Suppose I want to calculate factorial of 100. Factorial of 1000. Big number. Next, suppose I want to calculate the phi, Protean function. Is prime. I can test whether a number is prime or not. There is an inbuilt function is prime. Is prime is prime of 17, you know, whether 17 is prime or not, is prime of 70 is true, so it's prime. Is prime of 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, 7. Sorry, I have made a mistake. It will be in the bracket, round bracket. It is false. It is not prime. Since it is not prime, we can find the factors of this factor of 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, 7. Factor of this. Factors of 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, 7 is 19. 333, 378. These are all prime numbers. These are the prime factors. Next. I can find the phi of n, that is phi function. Phi of n, you know that phi of n is the number of integer less than n prime to n, less than n prime to n. Phi function. That's the comment. I have used is prime, then next about GCD. I will try it later. GCD of two number, GCD of suppose 34 and 78. GCD of two number is 2. LCM, it is LCM, just LCM. LCM of 45. 23. Now there is a part of XGCD. There was XGCD 34, 78. It will give three answers. One is, first one is the GCD. Second one is the minus 16, and the third one is 7. That means we know that GCD of any two number can be expressed as a linear combination of the numbers. Here, GCD of 34 and 78 is 2, but it can be expressed as 34 into some positive integer x and 78 into some positive integer y. Here, x is minus 16, y is 7. Let us verify this. We can verify this whether it is true or not. That means we will verify the two equal to equal. To compare equality, we will need two equal signs. So two is compared with, suppose minus 16 into here, first number is 34. Plus 7 into 78. So GCD is equal to the first number into this x and second number into y. let us test, that means run shift and enter, test shift and enter. This is false. Oh, this will be minus CT. This will be minus CT. Then this true. That means minus 16. Suppose I store this number as three variables, 1, comma B, comma C is equal. I can store in this way. ABC equal to DCB. Then I can show the value of ABC. In this way, I can store. To show the value of A, type A and shift enter. You will get the value B, with 2. And B, to show the value of B, type B and shift enter. B is minus 16. Then create an input cell. C is 7. Okay. You can also verify the GCD into LCM equal to product of the number. You can also verify this. Here the numbers are the 34 and 78. Let us verify this. GCD of any two number, we can take 34, 7, 09 arbitrary into.
Excuse me, sir. Sorry to disturb you.
Achha.
Shivani is asking how to get XGCD.
How to get XGCD? XGCD is an inbuilt function. XGCD of two numbers will give you a three output. One, first one is the GCD, and second one is a integer. Say third one is integer, such that GCD can be expressed as GCD, or suppose ABC equal to XGCD of 3478. Then A equal to B into 34 plus C into 78. Second number to store have a B, third number to store C. Okay. LCM of 34, comma.
Thank you, sir.
709 equal to the 34. It will be 34 star 709. I am testing whether it is GCD of two number into LCM two number is equal to product of the number. Is it true or not? Shift enter. This is true. Our result is verified. Then even any advanced function on number theory you can do with this HazMat. Is there any problem?
No, sir, please continue, sir.
Okay. Okay. I'm coming. I have covered factors, GCD, etc. Now I want to look at variable declaration. I want to look at variable declaration and defining function, etc.
Sorry to interrupt you again, sir.
Okay.
Sir, sorry to interrupt you. One of the students, participants is asking what is GCD. Moinath Chaturvedi is asking.
GCD.
What is GCD? Yes, sir.
GCD. GCD is greatest common divisor. GCD means greatest common divisor. GCD is greatest common divisor of two integers. You can calculate GCD of three numbers. Suppose GCD of three numbers. Suppose 4, 6, 8. It does not work. Okay. Then you can calculate it in this way. First, calculate GCD of 4 and 6. 4, 6. Then calculate GCD of 4, 8. Okay. These two. So first calculate GCD of 4, 6, then GCD of 4, 6 are 8 and GCD of 4, 6, 8. Then this it will give you the GCD of 4, 6, 8. Now I want to explore prime pi. What is prime pi? Prime pi is the number of prime that are less than or equal to x. Prime pi. Prime pi is the number of prime less than n. Next prime, you can calculate the next prime of a given number. Number of prime less than n. The prime pi. There is a function prime pi. Prime pi. Prime pi. Suppose prime pi of 20 means 8. The number of prime less than 20. Number of prime less than 20. You can make the least of all prime less than 20. So let's type least. List list of all prime less than 20. This does not work. Okay. Okay. This will not work. The prime pi, prime p. Again, I am writing prime. Prime pi. Prime pi argument is real number. The 20.4, suppose 23.54, the number of prime less than x, that is less than 23.4, it is 9. There is a result in number theorem, the limit x tends to infinity pi x by log x is equal to 1. There is a result in number theory. Limit x tends to infinity pi x by x log x equal to 1. This is known as prime theorem. You can prove this theorem.
Sir, can you repeat it again?
There is a theorem in number theory, the pi x is nearly equal to x by log x. Pi x is nearly equal to x by log x for large x. That means if x is very large, then limit x tends to infinity pi x by log x is equal to 1. That means pi x is comparable to x by log x when x is very large. Pi x is nearly equal to x by log x when x is very large. This theorem is a prime number theorem. You can verify this. Okay, you can verify this. Now, number of divisors. You can calculate number of divisors. Number underscore of this type of commands are actually commands in Python. Since SageMaths are built on Python, therefore, if you are expert in Sage, you will be expert in Python. These commands are borrowed from Python programming language. Number, underscore of, underscore, underscore divisors of n. Suppose n is 20. The number of divisors of 20. This is 6. This is denoted by tau n in number theory. Tau n. Tau of 20 is 6. Number of divisors of 20 is 6. You can make a table for first 100 numbers for tau n. Sigma, there is a function, there is an invalid function sigma of suppose 3, 2. What does it mean? Sigma 3, 2 means 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. Sum of square of the first three natural numbers. If you take 3 instead of 2, then the sum of third power of first 10 third powers, sorry, the sum of third powers of the positive divisors of 10. Of all the positive divisors of 10. All the positive divisors of 10. Sorry, this is 1, 1, 3. Let us verify let us take it is 12 and let us take is 3. This is 2044. If you take it suppose 4, small number, this is take as 2. What is this? The sum of squares of the positive divisors of 4. What are the positive divisors? 1, 2 and 4. 1, 2 and 4. The 1 square plus 2 square. Let us verify this result. That means 1 square. 1 carat 2 plus, sorry, it is converted to markdown. 1 square plus 2 square plus 4 square should be equal to sigma 42. Let us check whether it is true or not. Okay. It is true. That means sigma 42 means the sum of squares of the positive divisors of 4. Okay. Now, I want to move to variable. How to define variable? Variables are defined. Defining variable. You can use variable just like a is equal to 10. A is a variable. 10 is stored in a. B equal to suppose 45.2. That means 10 is assigned to A, 45 is assigned to B. A dot is prime, this type of command you can use. A the dot is prime, that means A is prime or not. A is prime. 10 is not a prime. What is wrong? Okay. False. A is not a prime. A is 10. A dot is prime. Whether A is prime or not. This is same as is prime A. This is same as is prime A. Is prime within bracket A. This is same. This type of command is actually Python command. This type of command is SageMath command. This is the difference. Okay. Now, you can find the number of digits of 2^3045. This is a very large number. You can calculate the number of digits in this way. N dot n digits, here n is this. Run this one. When you press shift enter, this cell is run. That means 2^3045 is stored in n. Now execute this cell. Then the number of digits in 2^3045 is 970. It's a very large number. If you type n, then press shift enter, your answer will come. To get the answer, you have to type in, then press shift enter, you will get the answer. And if you count this number of digits, then you will get the number of digits is 970. You can plot the number of prime in this way. It will be discussed later. Using help document, you can get help from SageMath. If you type vector, then press one question mark, you will what will you get? It is taking time. Suppose you want to know what can be done using vector, this will appear, and you can take help. Suppose here is some example of how vectors is used in sales. Vector of 500. These are the example. From this help, you can score yourself. Vector double question mark. You can use search doc prime. If you type this command, you will get more and more document. More documents on prime. Okay, use of dot tab. Suppose a is 23. Now you type a dot then tab. A tab. This type of menu will appear. And from this, there are a lot of commands that can be operate on it. You can select anyone. Okay. So suppose I want to perform n digits, is prime, next prime, next prime. So a dot next prime, then take the round number and shift enter. There's shift enter. So next prime, a dot next prime is 11. Here a is last one. This is not where you have to shift and enter to assign the value of 23 in A. You have to execute this, then execute this 29. So next prime of 23 is 29. Next prime of 23 is 29. Suppose this is 104. Then execute, you will get the wrong answer. Same answer, because same last value of A is taken. But if you execute this cell, then execute this statement, you will get the correct answer. Okay. use of dot tab. If the command is very long, you cannot remember this, you can use dot tab. Dot tab. Say variable, then dot, then press tab. Then a lot of options will appear. From this option, you can select one, anyone. Now, use of function. Suppose fx is this function. Fx is a polynomial. This is a polynomial. And type press enter. You want to find the coefficient of it. Coefficients of it. F dot, type f, and then dot, then press tab. A lot of options will appear. Then you find your appropriate option. Suppose coefficient. Coefficient shifts C. Coefficient, there must be a coefficient. This is then with a round bracket. Round bracket, why it is round bracket? Round bracket is it because this is treated as a function. This is treated as a function. Then shift enter. F dot coefficient. Something is going on. Anyhow, it is not working. What is the problem? Just okay, I will try it later. Suppose you want to plot the function f. Here, f is this function. It is the polynomial of degree 5. Like f dot, f, then dot, then plus tab. F dot, plus tab. You will get these options and choose the plot option. Plot. And then round it. Then press shift enter. It is running within the in it is running. This is the plot of it. You might be noticed that the input cells are numbered from 1 to 42, 48, 49, like this. Suppose here you want to make a subheading, then how can you do this? You can type hash, even double hash, if you have, then press one space, then type your subheading. Number theory function, number theory. Theory function. Then go to the code section and turn it markdown. Then run this code, run this cell. You will, the input cell will disappear and your heading will appear, will be created. Next. I want to look at plotting of graphs in 2D, plotting of graphs in 2D. Suppose you have this function, fx equal to 2x plus 6, 2x plus 6, this is straight line. So there is a function plot of fx. Since x is a variable which need not to declare, x is a variable, it is automatically by default x is a variable, you need not declare it. Okay,
sir.
You want to,
sir.
Okay,
sir, sorry to disturb you again, sir. 2 or 3 minutes more, then you can continue it from here to in the next day. Actually, we should start question answer session. There are lots of questions from students.
Okay,
otherwise,
okay.
We cannot wrap up. So you can take then we'll start.
अच्छा बोलती है अरे two बेसिन लोग plot tag को आलोचना करते हैं जिला में
ठीक है जी sir. हाँ okay 5 minutes है 5 minutes.
Okay. Suppose fx is 2x plus 6. 2x plus 6. You want to plot. The plot of fx. And x varies from minus 2 to 3. The range of x is supplied. Then type press shift enter. This is the graph of fx. Now suppose this is mx plus c. You have supplied the value of m is equal to 2 and supplied value of c as minus 3. Then plot fx from x varies from minus 2 to 3, then shift enter. This is the one. Now suppose you want to plot the graph of y equal to x square. Y equal to x square and your x varies from minus 1 to 1. You plot fx, x varies from 1 to minus 1 to 1. This is your graph. Now suppose you want to plot several plots in the same axis. Suppose m equal to 2, c equal to 0, y equal to mx plus c, y equal to mx plus c. This is fx, this is your fx. Fx equal to mx plus c. Fx is not written. In place of fx, you are writing mx plus c. X varies from minus 3 to 3. Second graph, m is equal to 2, c equal to 3, mx plus c. Third, this plot is stored in P1. This is a special operation in sales. This is an object. Plot is an object. This object is stored in P1. This is also an object stored in P1. This is also an object stored in P1. All are plot same function, mx plus c, with different m and c. Then, at last, P1 plus P2 plus P3. Is the command to plot this graph in the same axis. And press shift and enter to run this, you will get plotting colors and style. You can put the color is equal to green and line style equal to dash dot. Same plot. You are changing the, you are just adding the color and line style. Plotting of y equal to sin x for varying values of a. A equal to 1, sin ax. Here the function is sin ax. X varies from minus 2 pi to 2 pi. Here a is 1. When a is 1, the plot, the object is stored in P1. When a is 2, the object is stored in P2. When a is half, the object is stored in P2. But the color is red, here the color is red, here there is no color, line style is dash dot, dash, then P1 plus P2 plus P2. To show these graphs in one sheet, then press shift and enter to run this and get this. Plotting, for plotting purpose, SageMath is very good. Suppose I want to plot y equal to 7.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yes.
Huh.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
This is the last one. Okay.
Okay.
This is the last one. I want to play plot sine ax plus b. Player amplitude, sorry, frequency is varying. Frequency of the sine is varying, and b also varying. Play a and b have the different values. P1, P2, P3, then P1 plus P2 plus P3. Okay? Plot. In this way, you can plot x sine 1 by x. Suppose your plot, you want to plot x sine 1 by x. Play fx equal to x sine 1 by x, show f. Play, this will show the function. This is an object stored in f and show f. An object is showing by this command. Here, the function is showing. But if you plot the function f dot plot, x varies from minus 0.1 to 0.1. This is same, these two commands are same. These two commands are same. Actually, this is a SageMath command, or this is a Python based command. Since SageMath is built on Python programming, Python based command is also valid in SageMath. Okay, I stop here. If you have any question, you can ask me.
Okay, thank you, sir. Let's start the question answer session. There are some questions. First, Akanksha is asking how to download SageMath. Actually, not only Akanksha, there are several students who are completing that. Please explain, sir, how to download or install SageMath on SageMath.
Okay, this is very easy. First step, you have to go to the official website of SageMath. Official website of SageMath. Then, if you are using Windows system, then go to the Windows section. Download section. Then choose the correct installer for Windows base and download it, and then run the installer. Run the installer. And then click okay. It will take 30 or 35 minutes time, depending on your system performance. This is very easy. If you are using Linux system, it is also not difficult. Same. Try to explore. Try to explore and go to the official website, and if I can show you the steps. Is my screen visible?
No, sir. Suddenly your screen
now
has gone off. No, sir.
Now?
Okay, no, it's still not visible, sir.
Still not visible.
Okay, sir, actually you have already explained the procedure download.
Okay.
Install
okay.
In the beginning.
Okay, next
question. One of the students, Shayon Jana, is asking how can we find out Euler's phi function in SageMath? I mean, is there any, can we guide them or can we some instructions?
I'm trying. Euler phi function. Suppose
yes,
I am creating a cell here.
Sorry, not sir. Not visible, sir. Screen actually.
Oh, screen not visible. I am lost my sharing.
Share screen, sir. Please share screen again.
Okay. I am trying. Is it visible?
Yes, sir. It is absolutely visible.
Okay. Now, Euler phi function. Suppose I am writing Euler. Then press tab. There is an Euler phi function. Okay, Euler underscore phi. I did a mistake. I have typed phi first. That was the mistake. Euler phi. There is a function Euler phi. About Euler phi of k, that is, it should be 4, it is 4. Euler phi of k, that is, the number of prime less than 10 and prime to 2. Okay, if you want to find the Euler phi of 100, then it will like 40. Okay, next.
So
is it clear?
Yeah, yes, sir. So that means that basically the Euler phi function is a system defined function.
Inbuilt function.
Inbuilt function.
You can write your own function.
Yes.
You can write your own function. It will be discussed tomorrow.
Okay. How to program a function, that will be discussed tomorrow. And the Euler phi function is a system already defined in the system, inbuilt function. So you have to just write it properly, then you can use it. Okay, sir. Next question is, okay, sir. Aisharya Barkar is asking, sir, can you please explain once again what is prime phi function? What is prime phi function?
What is
prime phi function?
Sorry, I'm not getting the question.
Sir, what is prime phi function?
Oh, prime phi. Prime
phi. Yes, prime phi. Sorry.
Prime
phi, sir. Yes, sir.
Hmm. Prime phi function is, suppose the argument is x. Prime phi of x is the number of prime less than equal to x. Less than equal to x. So suppose prime phi of 10. The number of prime less or equal to 10. Less or equal to 10. মানে 10 এর চেয়ে কম বা সমান যত প্রাইম আছে সেগুলো হচ্ছে প্রাইম পাই অফ 10. ওকে,
ইয়েস স্যার, থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার, থ্যাংক ইউ. লেটস টেক দ্য নেক্সট কোশ্চেন. নেক্সট, শিবানী ইজ আস্কিং হাউ টু গেট নেক্সট প্রাইম, দ্যাট মিন্স ইজ দেয়ার এনি ইনবিল ফাংশন টু গেট
নেক্সট. দেয়ার ইজ এন ইনবিল ফাংশন. Next prime, next underscore prime, this type of command is there in actually Python. Next underscore Python prime, then your argument. Okay.
So Shivani, your doubt is clear now. So just write next underscore prime.
I am trying.
Next underscore prime. Okay, sir is writing. Okay.
Next, then underscore prime, then your argument. So it's 46 45 47. Next underscore
thank
prime of
48. Yes, sir, thank you very much, sir. Let's take next question. Okay, so one of the students is asking, what is Euler number? That also, sir, if you can help. That means he don't know
number.
The definition of Euler number actually. So what
Euler
is
Euler number? Euler number. Euler number is Euler gamma. Euler
yes,
gamma.
No, EN. Sorry, you have written E dot N. So that.
E dot N.
Yes, sir.
E dot, I mean, E is a rational number. E is a rational number. E to the
yes,
power
sir.
X, where X is equal to 1. It is E. It is an irrational number. Value of E is, this is Euler number. Okay.
Yes, actually due to the scientist Euler, this number
this
has been named as Euler number.
Okay,
Akanksha?
There is another question, another constant, Euler gamma. Euler
yes,
gamma in real analysis, 1 plus 1 by 2 1 plus 3 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4 dot 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 1 by n minus log n, this series is convergent and converges to gamma. Gamma is known as Euler gamma constant. There is another question, Euler gamma. You can type here Euler gamma. Euler underscore comma dot n. This is the Euler gamma. Okay, next.
Thank you, sir. Let's take next question. Okay, one of the participants just asked that can you explain what is the difference between SIGMAP and C language? Suppose one student already knows C language, so can they
C language concept in SIGMAP? C is a mathematical software. C is a general purpose low level language. It is a package software. In C is a